Hi, my name is Tammy Rowland. I am the creator of the Work Smarter, Earn More system, and I am delighted that you've come back again today. What we're going to be doing today is the Daily Productivity Planner, and the last video was about the Rowland Donoso Productivity Cycle, and each of them kind of dovetail onto the other to help you become more productive. And hopefully you've been taking notes and that this is really valuable to you, and you're going to find yourself getting so much more done every day and every week and every month than probably what you've done before. What you've got underneath, or when you received the video, you also received a copy or a download for yourself so that you could make a copy of this particular productivity planner, one for every working day that you have, so that you get a lot done and you're able to stay very focused and clear. And that's what drives us when we're the most successful, is our clarity and our ability to stay focused. And we talked a little bit about that in the last video, where it was about being focused and staying, you know, keeping attention to something. What we're going to talk about right now is the projects in the productivity planner. You'll notice on your copy that there were spots for three different projects, and I've just expanded one of them, and we're going to talk about it from here today. It doesn't matter what your projects are. If you've got a list of a dozen different projects that you're trying to get done, you may find it very difficult to stay on top of all of the things that need to be done. It's like they've got all these moving parts. So what I find is if you take the three that have the biggest impact for you based on what it is that they're going to do as far as a project goes, these projects that I'm doing, creating the video, writing an ebook, creating group programs, they're all about giving of value, being of service. They're about showing you my expertise so that you see me as an expert in productivity and efficiency. As a productivity coach, these are things that I work with my clients all the time, and it makes me a very efficient business person, and I see that efficiency showing up in all of my clients because they've learned how to use these things. So if you took your projects and you looked at each project and decided every day what five big things I must do to move this forward, you're going to have a very easy time filling in what these things are. At the beginning of creating the videos, it was much different than what the five things are today that I'm doing. But I kind of backtracked this a little bit. The first thing I had to do was, what was my purpose for creating these videos? And I had to sit down and script out some of that for myself, just so that I had full knowledge of what was this about? What was driving the idea of doing these videos for you? And it was to be of service, again, as I just said to you a moment ago. So once I sorted that out, it was really easy to figure out the rest. But I knew the five things that were major that had to be done were, what was my purpose? What's the content that I'm going to be doing and delivering for you that I thought would be of good value for you? Who was the videographer I was going to use when I was recording these? Because I didn't want to be using just my computer and my desk and not be doing it in a really professional way. I wanted it to be something that you'd be able to look at, see, get value, as opposed to just my shining face. I wanted to know whether I needed to have a studio and sort that out, which I kind of dovetailed on to here. I had to figure out if I had a space in my home that was appropriate or whether I'd have to rent the space. And that was something that I sorted out with my videographer as well, who is, you'll see his name at the end of the video if you're interested in getting some information, especially if you're local to Montreal. And also my marketing. How was I going to market these videos? How was I going to deliver them to you? What needed to be done in that? So each of these has several steps within them. But at the very beginning, it was just making decisions. And if I didn't know what the content was going to be, I wouldn't be able to move this forward. So each of these are very much five big things that I needed to do. If I looked at my next project, which is writing an ebook. Again, the first one was deciding what the ebook was going to be about. The second was, what was the content or the subject matters within that I wanted to have it done? So if I was doing 10 chapters, what are the 10 different things I want to talk about? And just break that down. So I just moved along as I was figuring out the top five things I needed to do in there, the same as creating a group program. What was that program going to be? How long is it going to be? Was I going to market it live as a live program? Am I marketing it as an online or a teleseminar, a webinar series? There's so many different ways. But these are all decisions that I had to make to be able to move these things forward. So the big thing is always looking at what are the five big things that I must do to move this project forward. And that'll help you keep moving every day a step towards getting these things completed, as opposed to them sitting on the corner of your desk collecting dust or avoiding them because the project just seems insurmountable. It seems so big that you can't possibly figure out where to go from there. And taking the time to do this will shorten the amount of time it takes to actually get the activities done, just because you're more clear about what it is you're trying to do, what it is that you want the end result to be in each of these projects and each of these steps of the project. And you may find that you have 55 things you need to do, but you're choosing the five things that are big that's going to get you closer to that goal. Okay, so the next thing we're going to go into is the priorities. Your priorities, you don't want to get them all confused with just activity. Your priorities are the main things that you must do, keyword here being today. Otherwise, it's not a priority. It needs to be completed today, no matter what. And that's kind of the boot in your backside that just says, move this forward. You can't just say, oh, it's okay if I leave it until tomorrow. What's really important that you give it a priority, you know, that you give it that asterisk, that exclamation mark at the end to say, this must be done. And it may be directly in link or in relationship to your projects, but it also may be driven by your primary things that you're trying to get done in your business. Whatever your calendar is saying, I must talk to my client to reschedule because I now have a doctor appointment at that moment and I can't hold that appointment then. That would be a priority, but it also is it's someone you must be in touch with. And that's also on your sheet that you've received that you can use every day. Some of the priorities you're going to find out are being driven by other people. It's what's coming in into your inbox. And that's what's written on the bottom of your priorities or of your productivity planner, which is before your inbox and before other people's stuff. Your inbox, you might think is a priority if you've spent the first 5 minutes of your day trying to figure out what's going on, what's happening in the world, what is Susie Q saying, what's Kendall Summerhawk or Brendan Burchard or whoever you're following saying. Maybe they have something cool and new I'd like to follow, or I'd like to do, or I'd like to buy, or I'd like to whatever. That may support your business very clearly, but it may not be a priority. It may be a time waster given what your priorities are, and certainly may not support your projects that you've got going on as well. So in the morning, do you know what you're going to be doing? They should be driven, or it's best if they're driven by your priorities. So your inbox is full of what other people want you to do, their agendas, not what you want to do, which is why I've written, stay focused on yourself. If you're not staying focused on you, it's so easy to follow somebody else's idea of what you need to be doing today. So every day, figure it out. Keep yourself focused. Write yourself a note. Put it on your computer. Put it in front of wherever it is you go to get your email, and write yourself a reminder that the email is just somebody else's idea of what they want. Unless there's a purpose for going in there and that you're looking for something very specific, which we'll go into in a moment, there's no need to be going there. There's no need to be going there. And schedule in like during your lunch break or whatever, like the same as your Facebook and your all your other social things that you do. You do them in off times or not primary working hours, which may be different from one person to the next. Because it's such a time eater, that's why that's written on there as well. Make sure that you're spending your priorities correctly. So my priority for creating videos today, my key priority was to make sure that I had my hair cut, that I'd because I had it scheduled for this morning and I knew I was being videoed today, so it just made sense to pick today. Another key thing that I needed to do was to make sure that I was prepared and ready for the content I was going to be delivering to you today and to have this video completed today. Another priority would be to the editing from the previous video. So each of these things has a really important time component so that I can move it on. If I okay it, then I can send it to my VA and have her start doing the marketing plan around that and have it put in the right place so it connects up. There's all these different steps that need to be done for each part of the project. So that's part of the marketing that has to be done, and that's a priority that must be done today. So in your project, what you've got running in front of you, what is the priority in that project that must be done today to take that project forward. So take the time to figure that out. If you don't take the time to figure that out, you're going to be, you'll probably be treading water or spinning your wheels or whatever thing you want to call it. But if you're not doing it, you're going to find your priorities are just kind of wishy-washy. And if you can push it off to tomorrow, it's not a priority. So make sure you're really looking at what it is you want to get done. And then you're drawn towards it because you're excited to get those projects further along. All right. So the next thing you'll notice on the boxes that you've got on your page is that people drive your business. So they'll always be your number one priority. And you want to make sure that you're dealing with the people that are that you have contact with. And there's a lot of different things that are important. You've got both listing the people that you need to reach out to. Where are you? And they may be connected to your projects, or they may be connected to sales or marketing or some aspect of your business, clients that you already have that you need to have contact with. But you need to know whether it's projects, prospects, affiliates, if you're doing affiliate marketing, who we're going to be the owl person here. Who is it that you need to reach out to? And the last list is the people that I'm waiting on or that I need something from. That can be all kinds of things. That can be someone you're waiting to send you some information. I'm waiting to okay a marketing page for my VA. That's someone that I've got on this list. I have two or three people that I've met recently that I would like to get to know a little bit more and see if there's some way I can be of service to them. Their names would be on this list, on the list of who I'm going to be reaching out to today. And it's back and forth based on what it does is if it's people you're waiting on something, this is, especially if it was an email, this you're going to go to your email and you're looking specifically from these people. If they aren't in your inbox, then you move back to your own priorities before you go back and you look for any other ones that are potential clients who are emailing you. You don't want to lose them either. But first off is the people that you've already reached out and you've already done, they've been on this list and now they're on this list. So it's pulling them through and getting that information. You decide if they're not in your inbox yet or they're not on your voicemail yet, do they need to be reached out again today? Or if you don't hear from them by tomorrow morning, they go back on this list and you have to contact them again. So it's just about being on top of the people that are in your life or in your business that'll help drive your business forward. We are not an island. We work with other people. We need other people. We want other people to be in our lives. And the best way to do that is being on top of these kinds of things. I've even used this when it comes to personal relationships in some way, shape, or form. I've found ways to make different connections with people. Even my sons, I have a FaceTime appointment every Friday morning with so that I stay connected with him. It may seem ridiculous to have my son on my calendar, but it's the way that it's important enough for me to stay connected with him. It's important enough for him to have that contact. My other son, it's a different relationship and it's a different kind of contact, not as regimented. But it makes a difference depending on the relationship. So I even take these kinds of things into my personal life. How do I stay in contact with people? Because they're important to me. So I have friends I do those kinds of things with as well. If I've asked a friend something and I'm waiting for some information back or something that I need from them, they might be on this list too, but they may not be on the top of the list because my business might be driving this list more than anything else. But it might be in my agenda. It might be on my on the calendar somewhere as something that I'm going to be doing because it's I don't want to forget. You know, people are important to me, as are relationships and relationship building. And to have a really successful business, you will have had to build relationships with people, as I'm hoping I am with you. I'm hoping that you find that the content that I'm giving you has high enough value that you're trusting, you're learning to trust what I have to say and what I have to offer. And with that, hopefully, you know, it's something that you're going to, you know, go onto the website and get your free worksheet. There's a blueprint for you that's around building your vision. There's an opportunity for you to receive my newsletter, which comes out monthly, which will keep you on top of any events as well. So make sure you go to tammyrolandcoaching.com and check those things out and sign up for something so that you're in the know of what else I have going on and what I have offering, in case this was forwarded to you by a really caring and kind friend who already knows, likes, and trusts me. And that, as a business owner, is what you want. You want your potential clients to know, like, and trust you. So if you have any questions, please don't hesitate to, you know, put a quote or throw a question out to me either in the comments below or send me an email, and I'd be happy to answer any of your questions. Outside of that, you just want to make sure that you've done what you need to do on that sheet and you can carry things forward, as long as you're not always finding yourself carrying forward priorities. Because if that's the case, there's something else that's keeping you from stepping up, keeping you from moving forward in your business. And if that's the case, then it's about taking the time to figure that out. What is it that's keeping you from moving forward? And watch for the next video in this series, and I believe it'll be the last video, and it'll be 10 tips for being productive and efficient. And they'll be based on my Work Smarter and More system. So I'm looking forward to talking with you one more time. I'm delighted you've taken the time out today. I hope you're living the life you love, and that you love the life that you live, and that you are working to the best of your ability to be as successful as you know that you can be, because I know you can be greatly successful. Thanks for coming. Have a great day. Hi again. By the way, don't go away. Make sure you download the Daily Productivity Planner, one for every working day that you do right now. And if you can answer one, two, or all three of the questions in the comments below, I would be delighted to have a conversation with you there as well. The first question is what one thing will you do that's going to make a difference in how you're working your business every day? It's going to make you more efficient. What one thing would that be? The second question would be, are you as effective as you truly want to be? That effectiveness, you may find that you're effective in some areas, but not in all of them. But as a whole, are you as effective as you'd like to be? And the third question is, how was this video helpful? Just as a whole, is there something in particular that really struck you overall that really does make a difference for you? And you can see where it'll make a big difference moving forward, like an aha of some form. I look forward to having a conversation with you again. www.tammyrolandcoaching.com. Please feel free to forward this on to a friend who might need some help with their productivity as well. Have a great day.